Hello, welcome back to another video, and this video I'm gonna show you how I pulled off this over here. So this title is, this Minecraft video has 222 views, 53 likes and 11 dislikes. And as you can see, that's correct, and that's also correct. So a lot of people wanted me to make a tutorial on how to do this. There's also some comments, I think, asking for that. And so this video will show you how to create this for yourself. And so the first thing you want to do is actually record your video. So this is the video you're going to upload, and it's going to have this title. So I first recorded this video and then I created this title later. So this is something you have to do because you need the YouTube URL over here. You need this code to get this to work. So first of all, start recording your video and upload it to YouTube. So I will do that as well. So I've already recorded a little video, so I'm going to upload it now. Here we go. So I'm just going to upload this video over here. And then what you want to do is, over here in the title, you're already gonna create your title. So for example, I don't know, OMG, this video has, and then put for now X views and Y likes and Z dislikes. So you can just do the views or just do the likes or do any combination, that's totally fine. So I just call it X, Y, and Z, so I know where I'm going to put the amount of views, the amount of likes, and the amount of dislikes. So this should be enough, and then you can just do your description, that's fine. Upload a thumbnail and do all of that. This is the most important part, and then once it's finished processing, you can upload it. So that this can be private, that's totally fine. So you want to get it on private first, so you can change the title first before actually publishing it, then save it. Then go over to your video, and you could copy the link before, but just get shareable link, that's fine. You get a link copied to clipboard, and now we will actually start doing the code. So what you want to do is go over to Google and type in script.google.com. There we go. And you should get over here, like this. And here's the API for my previous video. So now I'm just going to start a new project. So you will get this screen over here with the code, and then the first thing you want to do is go over to Resources, Advanced Google Resources, type in your project name, so this could be anything, doesn't really matter. I'm going to call it Tutorial, there we go. And then you should wait for a couple of seconds because then a menu should pop up. Okay, there we go, the menu popped up. Now you might have to accept some terms and services, and you will just have to go to the site and accept the terms of services, and then you can go back over here. So what you want to do is go to the bottom, all the way to the bottom is YouTube Data API, YouTube, and you want to click over here on off and switch it to on, click OK, and there we go. Now it says updating advanced Google server settings, and now it should work. So you can change the name of your code over here by clicking here, rename if you want to, doesn't really matter. There we go, just save it as tutorial code, and now you want to actually copy in the code, so this is in the description below. So here we go, we got this. And now the first thing you want to do is change out the YouTube ID. So go back to your private video and once again copy the link like this. Go back and copy that over here instead of this. Copy it and then add two slashes in front of it if you forgot those. Then copy the last code and put that over here like this. So now this all should work fine, and over here we have video views count, so this will be the amount of views the video has, and this is just where it gets it from. Then I also have like over here and dislike, and you could add some stuff yourself as well. So you could do var video, well, I don't know what else there is, so I'm just gonna do two, doesn't really matter. This is just the name of your variable. Then do video statistics dot. And then here you can see the things you can find. So this is the amount of comments, the amount of dislikes, the amount of favorites, the amount of likes, and the amount of views. So you can add the comments if you want to by pressing enter. And if you decide you don't want to use some of these, then you don't need to delete them. You can just let them, well, stay in the program. So if you just want views, just add views in the title later on, and you can let the other ones stay there. You can also remove them, that's fine, but you don't have to. So that's just something I wanted to say. And now there's also something important you have to do for this program. So what you have to do for every single one of the lines in this code, you have to add a semicolon at the end of each line. So make sure you do that, and make sure you don't forget any if you add any new lines of code. And then there you go, you also got the amount of comments, so I'll rename that now, comment count. There we go. And then over here is going to be your title. So for me, that was this micro video has this amount of views, this amount of likes, and this amount of dislikes. So you can change this to how you want it. Just make sure you have parentheses around the text and then no parentheses around the actual counts. So I'll copy in the title I chose. Here we go. Put this in between the parentheses like this. And then you want to isolate these X's. So put some parentheses around them like this. Around the X, around the Y, and around the Z. There we go. Then you can remove the X, space, plus, add video views count like this. Space, plus, space. Then over here, we can add the same thing. So just copy and paste it like this. And here as well. Like that, and then just set like here, like this, like, and dislike over here. So you have to make sure that you actually spell this right with the right capitalization. You could also just copy it from over here, that's fine as well. So as we already got, also got the comment, so we can add that as well, dislikes, and parentheses, video comment count, so it doesn't really matter, you can add stuff, that's fine. Okay, like that. And then this is the part where it actually changes the title. So now we're done here and we can click save like that. And now we can run it for the first time. So there will be a screen authorization required and you can click review permissions. And then you have to go to your own channel. So I will do this on Mac stuff. Click that and it says this app isn't verified. Just go into advanced and click go to tutorial unsafe. That's fine. It actually does work. So now we can allow it. There we go. And now it should work. So it says running the function. And now if we go back to our video and refresh, we should see that the title has updated. And yes, it has. So we can go to details, see it. So the title is now, oh my god, this video has 0 views and 0 likes and 0 dislikes and 0 comments. So there's no space in between here. So this could happen that you make a little mistake. And let's see, what's this mistake? Yes, I didn't add a space over here. So that's necessary to add a space in the title as well. So when we run it again, it will actually work. So now let's go over to the video. Because we're not done yet, we have to make it automatic, which we haven't done just yet. So we can like the video and comments are not supported, so we can switch it over to an unlisted video. So the title won't automatically update just yet, but now we can comment on it. Wow, awesome. There we go. And now if we run the code again over here, just run it to check if it actually works. So there we go, running the updating title function. And let's refresh, let's see if it worked. There we go, one like, one comment. And the view didn't come in yet because I'm on my own account, so it won't come in. But let's watch this video, by the way. Make sure to like the video, subscribe, turn on notifications, maybe join the channel, and check out my merch! Strange video. Okay. Now we need to update this automatically. So we go back over here. Now we go into Edit and Current Project Triggers over here. So there's no results, so we can add one like this. And here you see the update title function. And now what you want to do is go over to our timer, because we don't want to do this every hour. You can change it to minutes, and let's do it every 10 minutes. That's also what I have for my other video, and that works perfectly fine, because there is a limit on how many you can do during a day. So just set it to 10 minutes, that will be fine. And we won't need any notifications for failures, because there's going to be a lot of failures. Just so you know that, because my previous one had a failure percentage rate of like 15%. But that's still fine, so 8 out of 10 times it still works. So now we click save, like that. And there should be this over here, and update title. So this will do it every 10 minutes. But for now, I will put it every minute, so we can actually see it working, without having to wait that much. So there we go. But just keep it on 10 minutes for your one. So I'm gonna dislike the video and I'm gonna add some more comments. So I haven't clicked run on the function again, so hopefully it will actually automatically update now. So let's see if it already worked. No, not yet. So we'll have to wait for a minute until the function will work. So I'm just gonna refresh the page a couple of times until it has updated. There we go. It already got the 4 comments. Well, there should be five, but it has now has one view, one dislike, and four comments. So it didn't get one of the comments. But as you can see, it also didn't load that comment over here. So that's why it only says four comments. So this should work now. If you have any more questions, please let them know in the comments, and I will try to help you out. But that was it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this video. Then please leave a like. And if you like my other content, then please consider subscribing. And I hope to see you in my next videos. Until then. Bye-bye!